Hey guys, Mr. Backbrook here. In this video, we're going to look at the derivative of log base a of x. So as we're finding the derivative of log base a of x, what we're actually going to do is rewrite this using natural logs so that we can use what we know about the derivative of natural logs to help us out. So we can use a change of base formula to take log base a of x and turn it into the natural log of x over the natural log of a. And then we're going to take the derivative of that. So if we want to do the derivative of the natural log of x over the natural log of a, we're differentiating this with respect to x. So where we have this natural log of a on the bottom, we can actually separate that off of there. Now, because it's on the bottom of the fraction, it's technically 1 over the natural log of a, but I'm going to take that and pull that out to the front. Again, because that doesn't have any x's in it, so doing the derivative with respect to x doesn't affect that at all. So now we're really multiplying that by the derivative of just the natural log of x, since we took that 1 over the natural log of a out of there, and the derivative of the natural log of x is 1 over x. So we have 1 over the natural log of a times 1 over x, but we're going to write that as 1 over x natural log of a. So the derivative of log base a of x is 1 over x times the natural log of whatever that a base is. Now, like we've mentioned before with some of our other trig functions, this x in here might itself be a differentiable function. So if we're looking at the equation y equals log base a of some differentiable function u, then as we're doing this derivative in here, then we would have to apply the chain rule as necessary. So the derivative here would be 1 over whatever that u is, times the natural log of a, but then we would have to attach whatever the derivative of that inside function u is because of the chain rule. So in this example, we've got the equation y equals log base 2 of x squared, and we're going to do the derivative here. So for the derivative, I notice that we have an inside function, so we are going to have to use the chain rule. So this is going to be 1 over whatever's on the inside, so x squared, times the natural log of the base value, so 2, but then we have to multiply this by the derivative of that inside function. So the derivative of x squared is 2x. Now, because we're dealing with some fractions in here, I'm going to take that 2x and put it over 1. Then multiplying these together, this would turn into 2x over x squared natural log of 2. And then what I notice in here is that we've got this x on top and we've got a couple of x's on bottom, so there's actually some more simplifying that we can do. I can cancel out this x on top with one of those x's on bottom, so we end up getting 2 over x natural log of 2. We're not allowed to cancel these 2's out because on the bottom we're doing the natural log of 2. So we're performing this operation on the 2, so it's not safe to cancel those out. So this would then be our final answer here. In this example, we're going to take a look at the derivative of the equation y equals log base a of a raised to the sine of x power. And we're going to do it the long way first, and then we'll go through and do it a shorter way the second time around. So we're doing log base a raised to the sine of x. So if we use our log base a derivative rule, then as we start differentiating things in here, this is 1 over whatever this inside function is. So that's a sine of x. So I'm going to put that on the bottom down here. But then we have to multiply by the natural log of whatever that base a is. But now notice this has an inner function in it, so we have to attach the derivative of that based on the chain rule. So this is an exponential function with an a base. So the derivative rule for exponential functions says first you leave it the same, so this stays as a sine of x, but then you attach the natural log of a, whatever that a base is. But there's also an inner function on this a to the x. There's that sine of x. So we have to do another round of chain rule with that. So the derivative of sine of x is the cosine of x. So this was a two-link chain in here. Now, as we start putting some things together, I'm going to take all of this stuff on the end and put it over 1 so that we can multiply it to that fraction in the front. So we're going to have a sine of x times the natural log of a times the cosine of x all over a sine of x times the natural log of a. Now, what I notice is that we've got an a sine of x on top and on bottom, so those cancel each other out. I notice that we have a natural log of a on top and on bottom, so those cancel each other out. So we're left with just the cosine of x as our derivative. So that's the long way going through this. The short way, if you have a log with a base that matches the base of your exponential, those are inverses of each other, so they would actually cancel each other out. So we could have canceled those out right away from the beginning, which then turns our equation into just y equals the sine of x. And then if we want to do the derivative of that, the derivative of sine of x is the cosine of x. That's going to be it for this video. Thanks for watching.